Hi guys and welcome to today's video. Today's video is all about the Afghan Hound. Before we go on, don't forget to like and share if you enjoy our content. Please hit the subscribe button to get notified when we post more dog-related content. Liking and sharing our content helps massively with the growth of our channel, so it's very much appreciated. Also, if you're struggling to train your dog or are thinking about getting a puppy, then affordable online professional training is what we suggest. See the link in the description and the pinned comment for more info. Afghan Hound. Afghan Hounds are aristocratic and loving dogs who can run up to 40 miles per hour and require a serious grooming routine. Learn more about caring for an Afghan Hound and if it's the right dog for your family. There's no getting around this one. The Afghan Hound is known for its hair. That luxurious coat can come in just about any color and is usually kept long and silky. It'll require some degree of regular grooming. But the good news is that Afghan Hounds shed so infrequently, they're categorized as hypoallergenic dogs. As medium-large dogs, clocking at around 50 to 60 pounds. They're not lap dogs, but can be a good fit for an apartment dweller if taken out regularly. Just keep in mind that an Afghan Hound, while intelligent, is also very independent. They're not easy to train, and their temperament is often compared to that of a cat's. If you're training an Afghan, remember to avoid yelling. Find out what motivates your dog, whether that's treats, toys, or praise, and be ready with lots of time and patience. That being said, the right Afghan Hound with the right owner can be a match made in heaven. Afghan Hound appearance. Talk about glamorous, an Afghan Hound absolutely fits that description. With their flowing silky hair, long face, and solemn gaze, it's no wonder that this breed has been a symbol of status and grandeur for thousands of years. The American Kennel Club breed standard is especially poetic. They say he has a straight front, proudly carried head, eyes gazing into the distance as if in memory of ages past. Afghan Hounds are tall dogs, measuring 25 to 27 inches at the shoulder, but they're not stocky. They generally weigh just 50 to 60 pounds, making them a medium-large breed. Their long face has a prominent nose, giving them a slightly Roman appearance. Their ears are long, and their eyes are dark and almond-shaped. Finishing it all off is a long, thin tail that curls upward into a ring. Their most defining characteristic is, of course, that coat. Long, silky, and flowing, it could almost belong on the head of a 70s pop diva. The hair is shorter on the face and saddle, and the dog will have a top knot of longer hair on the head. The Afghan Hound can come in any color, but solid colors are most common. White markings are discouraged by breed purists, especially on the head. All these traits come with a practical purpose. That coat? It kept them warm in the high mountains where they were bred as hunters. Their especially large paw pads were designed to protect them from rocky terrain. And their highly flexible hips enabled them to turn quickly in small areas. Afghan Hound temperament. The Afghan Hound temperament is a unique one. Afghan Hounds are known to be reserved and aristocratic creatures, though their owners know they have a playful side. They are described in their standard as aloof, yet gay. That means that they have a comical side to them and they do need an active owner that wants to spend time with their dog. But not the intense companionship that you'd get from a retriever or a working dog. The Afghan, with unfamiliar people, is a little bit more standoffish. Not aggressive, just not as affectionate, not as comfortable with intimate handling, like petting and so forth. Afghan Hounds are not the type of dog who will jump all over you when you come home. But while they're not the face-licking type, they do become attached to their owners and can be quite affectionate. There's one myth that Afghan Hound lovers would like to dispel. People think this breed is unintelligent. The problem is sometimes we relate smartness to trainability. It's not that the Afghan Hound is dumb, but more that it's independent. The Afghan Hound is not your average dog. It is a free-spirited thinking, highly intelligent animal. Afghan Hound living needs. As a sight hound, the Afghan Hound does need the space to run full out several times a week. Since they're powerful jumpers, any space in which you let them run off-leash should be securely fenced. And it's important to keep them on a leash when going on walks and hikes to keep them safe. Sighting a squirrel can be enough to make them run into traffic. The prey drive is so strong within them that they will go in an instant. They can make wonderful apartment dogs, as long as you give them enough exercise. You have to be an active person to own an Afghan Hound. Afghan Hounds don't bark much, shed infrequently, and drool very little, making them easy indoor companions. They can be taught to get along with cats and other animals. However, small running animals can excite their prey drive. They can be good with children if properly socialized from the time they are puppies. And they can tolerate being left alone, though of course, as with any dog, Regular physical and mental stimulation is important. Afghan Hound care. The Afghan Hound's grooming needs are fairly specific. But the more you do it, the less arduous it becomes. The first and most important step is regular brushing. Once your Afghan is an adult, make sure you brush daily, or at least for several hours a week. This will help to remove mats, tangles, and debris. The longer you delay, the worse the matting will be later. So be sure to brush them on the regular. Bathe them regularly, two, around once a week. Some Afghan Hound owners also like to condition the coat after shampooing. The good news is that they shed minimally compared to other breeds. This means that they're often categorized as a hypoallergenic breed. Plus, if you want to minimize hair care, you can also take them to the groomer for a puppy cut. Or get a short haircut that is just a couple of inches long. Training an Afghan Hound might be the bigger challenge. A lot of people are getting Afghan Hounds for the wrong reasons. They want the beautiful, flowing, Farrah Fawcett-looking dream dog. They don't realize that they're getting a conniving, small petty thief on their hands. The difference between an Afghan Hound and other dogs can be put this way. If your dog is used to getting dinner at 6 p.m. but you happen to be late one day, a Border Collie might have a meltdown. The Afghan Hound, on the other hand, will open the fridge, help themselves to some dinner, and shut the door behind them. The first way to get a jump start on training is to find an Afghan Hound from a reputable breeder who begins socializing the puppies from a very young age. Time and patience are key when training an Afghan Hound. Also, finding the right motivation can be crucial. You've got to find something that they enjoy and then be patient with the process. It's also important to remember that they can be quite sensitive. Always avoid yelling. You can't be hard on an Afghan. They get their feelings hurt kind of easily. They get overwhelmed easily. Because training an Afghan Hound can be so demanding, they're not generally recommended for first-time dog owners. However, if you're a first-time dog owner and want to make the commitment, do your research. Reach out to local Afghan Hound groups for advice and support. The last thing an Afghan Hound advocate wants to see is a dog given up because the owner just wasn't a good fit. Afghan Hound health. Afghan Hounds have a relatively long lifespan for such a large breed, about 12 to 15 years. According to the AKC, they are generally healthy. As with all large and deep-chested dogs, it's important for owners to recognize the symptoms of bloat. This is a condition in which the stomach fills with gas and cuts off circulation to other organs. When this happens, it's important to get your dog to the vet, fast. Afghan Hounds can also be prone to hip and elbow dysplasia. This is a condition in which the hip or elbow joints in which the joint socket is deformed and eventually causes crippling lameness. Be sure that your breeder has screened the puppy's parents for this condition. And, like other sighthounds, Afghan Hounds have very low body fat and can be sensitive to anesthesia. Always take your dog to a vet who is familiar with the needs of sighthounds. That brings us to the end of this video on the Afghan Hound. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And hopefully, we'll see you in the next one.